What's up, YouTube? It's Yabba.
And Kari, what's good, y'all? We back with another video.
And
Kari's sick, y'all. I'm sick. But I still made it here, you know what I'm saying? Still up. Got the YouTube video. Okay, anyway. Make sure y'all like, comment, and subscribe. I'm going to put some stuff on my lips. Follow us on Instagram. the links is up here somewhere.
Yeah.
Follow Yabba's music channel because you know what I'm saying. She got a video coming out soon, y'all.
Yes, sir.
I'm going to tell you about it.
Mm-hmm. The song called Outlaws. Mm-hmm. I don't know if y'all want to see a little clip or not, but I'll do that for the next. I'll do that after it drops, so it's going to drop this weekend. So when it drops this weekend, I'll put it in a little clip and give y'all a snippet, I guess. But let me know. You know, if y'all did go click on my music link, let me know so I can know that you, you know, went out and supported. Also, let us know how y'all like this new setup. Y'all hate it? Y'all like it? How y'all feel? Let us know and then we can try to fix it up because it's new and we obviously haven't done it other than our live stream. Mm-hmm. If you weren't there, we played Among Us with the gang. Please go ahead, check it out, and we'll hit you up and, you know, and text y'all back. So, with that being said, today what we doing is Elvis Presley, Why Me Lord, live in Memphis, 1974. So let's get to the video.
Thank you. I'd like to ask J.D. Salmon to stay up to sing one of my favorite songs, Why Me Lord.
Why Me Lord.
Like, comment, subscribe.
Why his voice so deep? What the heck? So let me tell y'all what I think. One, when the first two came on, scared the shit out of me. Cause I'm like, oh my god, is this guy?
That wasn't even a tenor. That was like a.
That was a. Super
bass.
It was deep. Yeah. I know it's a baritone, but his voice is really deep. So when Elvis came in, Elvis has this really nice like mid tone. That's just like. He has a nice. Mm-hmm. Okay, don't judge me, people in the comments, okay? I've never really listened to Elvis. A lot of the reasons, just, I guess, you know, I watch a lot of, like, Black history movies and just reading up about Black musicians, because I'm a Black musician, and I know that some of the songs, you know, he didn't write. So I kind of just never went to him because I knew some of his songs were from Black artists that, you know, they didn't get credit for it. So I understand, but I never really, like, went out to really listen to Elvis ever. And I did a disjustice to myself because at the end of the day, regardless of what the music was, he's a really, really talented singer. He has an amazing voice.
He has a very nice voice. Mm-hmm. I haven't gone out of my way to listen to any of his music, but I know his catchphrase, which is that thank you.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. If you don't know that, then I don't know.
And the legs, and the legs. We all know the legs. Mm-hmm. You know, I know. That's really all I know about Elvis. Like, if I'm gonna be honest, I'm not American born, so obviously wasn't born with the, you know, my grandparents or my great grandparents telling me about Elvis. That wasn't something for me. When I really got into music, I started with reggae. Then it was blues, jazz. I don't really love jazz, but I did listen to jazz. But it really, really started with classical. When I first started music, reggae and classical music were my favorite. So then I went into the blues, and blues hit me in a different way. So, and that's what kind of led me more into rap, because I just feel like it takes so much from blues, and obviously, you know, I could talk about music history and the music theory all day long. But going back to Elvis, that's the reason why I didn't went out and, like, look at his music, listen to his music. But if I'm being honest, he has an amazing voice, like an amazing, amazing voice. And, you know, maybe I will go ahead and listen to some of his songs. It just has to be original ones. I really rank artists in a sense of, you know, it's fine for you to, you know, sing over someone's song, but you have to give them credit. Mm-hmm. You know, and I know that wasn't a thing back then, so I can't fault him for it, but, you know, I can only speak from where I'm at now. I can't fault him for it because I don't know what was going on back then. I wasn't there, so I can't say anything. But those artists should have gotten credit. You know, your family, his family is probably well off right now. And some of those artists' families, you know, probably the songs that he have made big were already big before him, and they're not getting that money that they originally wrote, or, you know. It's like a cover song. Imagine I know the cover songs get a lot more bigger than the original songs nowadays sometimes, but, you know, like Whitney Houston's song. But at least Dolly Parton got credit. Everybody knows Dolly Parton. So. Yeah. And Dolly Parton version was tough, too. You ever heard I Will Always Love You by Dolly Parton? I can't knock Whitney's version. Whitney's version is definitely the best. But when Dolly sing that song, you feel it with Whitney, but it's not the same. You like Whitney's version because it's like, I mean, like, classically, like, the way she sings it, top tier. But Dolly Parton, you feel the pain. Like, somebody hurt. Yeah. Like, it sounded like somebody hurt. I didn't even know until, I told y'all, I got really deep into music at one point. And that's why I started writing myself, because I didn't want to sing anyone else's songs.
Yeah. Well, I was 10 years old when I found out that Dolly Parton sang that song.
So, oh, really? Yes.
Yeah. See, we learn things every day, guys.
Yeah, so what you think about Elvis? What you think about this song?
The song was very slow for my taste.
Okay. But it's a gospel song, I think.
Yes, I was going to say it's a gospel song, so it's a little on the slower side. But I do feel like I would like to know the context behind this song and what led him to write it, if it was his writing.
Oh, he didn't write this. He said this was his favorite song.
Oh, okay.
I don't think he wrote it. If he wrote it, don't quote me.
I will research it to find out. But
I kind of like the song, though.
I would like to know what led him to write this song, because it just sounds like very, it comes from a different place than I can hear. So.
I don't know who wrote it, but I like the ending. I really like the beginning, because is it normally written with a baritone in the beginning? Like, if it isn't, then did he hear the, because I think the baritone kind of gives you like a, what the heck, like, you want to listen to the song.
I'm sorry, what is this song gonna be?
Yeah, this is tough. I'll definitely have to look into Elvis more and read up more about him. So I you know, I'll have a little bit more of an understanding, because I don't necessarily, you know, want to just write off an artist, especially one so, you know, renowned, you know. It's like when I first was listening to the Beatles, like, I literally searched for a Beatles song. I mean, I'm still, like, I'm a Beatles fan. Like, I love the Beatles. Okay, I mean, name a song, I probably know it. That's how serious it is. I love all genres of music. So, you know, I part of me now, especially, you know, 23, birthday was a couple weeks ago, it's like, you know, for me to have written something off is probably, you know, in the long run, still not the best thing to do. You know, you still want to get as much information and learn from them, because, you know, he's a great for a reason, you know? So, that's my little take. With that being said, we love you guys. Let us know what you think. Like, comment, subscribe. Give us your opinions, so we know what y'all going to. Let us know if y'all, how y'all rock with Elvis. I mean, we talked about so much things in that little small segment, but, you know, let us know your thoughts on everything. We'll try to comment back as much as possible. Let us know when y'all first actually found our channel and what video you found it on. And with that being said, we'll see you.
Bye.